time waiting for that second chance, for a break that would make it okay. There's always some reason to feel not good enough, and it's hard at the end of the day. I need some distraction.
What's going on, Duck Nation? College Football Nation, this is UODuckBros back for my favorite, your favorite,
definitely
the entire state of Oregon's favorite recap video of the best thing that has happened in a long time. How many times, if I may ask you, how many times in a row has Oregon beaten Washington? I think it can be summed up by a simple item that was on this pool table that we're filming this on, and it is this.
The old 10 spot.
Boy, that was green. That would have been way better.
The only thing that would be better would be if it was 20 years, but that's okay. We'll take 10 for now.
See, the best thing about this is that we won the decade.
We won the decade.
Oregon won the decade. They did what even Washington in their heyday couldn't even do.
Yep.
They won 10 years in a row.
Yep.
Oregon owns Seattle.
We do. We stormed Seattle. We have made Seattle our home. We have made Husky Stadium our house. We have completely dominated this series. As a matter of fact, as it stands still, even after this game, Washington has only led
for three minutes in the last 10 years.
So if that tells you how lopsided this is, I mean, every Duck fan that's a real Duck fan that's not just been born in the last couple years or just decided to be a Duck fan knows what the significance of this means. This means that...
Sure. Washington's still ahead by 15 in the whole series.
That's true.
Doesn't really matter, though, because you have not won a game in this series in a decade.
And you can cling on to your series lead, which will keep getting chopped down every single year. You can cling to your two national championships.
They're going to lose again next year.
I know they are.
Without Teeth Price, God save.
No Austin Seferian Jenkins, and Bishop Sankey's probably going to go to the league. Even if he doesn't, it won't matter.
He's going to go to the league because I think he knows what's in store. Because let's be honest, who the hell is their backup? Kyler Miles? Is that what his name is?
Siler Miles,
sure,
yeah.
Whatever it is. He's not going to be the savior of the program, that's for sure. And they're going to Eugene next year, and it's going to be another one of those where we're going to take you right out back
to the woodshed,
and we're going to clean your colon worse than one of them burritos with extra guacamole sauce.
At midnight after you've been drunk.
Yes. From Muchas Gracias. So, now, am I going to be the guy that says, well, we just went in there and kicked your ass? Well, not quite.
But it was a 21-point win. And this is definitely the best defense you've had in the entire decade that you have played us and have lost.
And that third-ranked pass efficiency defense
definitely got exploited today.
It really wasn't there that day.
Mm-mm.
It really wasn't. Oregon definitely racked up over 600 yards of offense, and they look damn good doing it.
Yep.
Also, Keith Price for being back in form, as they have been saying this whole season.
Right.
Oh, he's looking the way that he was supposed to. You know, he's looking the way that we knew he could be.
After copying Oregon's offense.
See, this is what happens when you copy one's offense. And I don't care what anybody says about, well, they're not copying Oregon's offense. They're just doing what's popular right now because everybody's doing the spread offense. No. You copied Oregon's offense. Sarkisian admitted that they copied Oregon's offense. And we showed you, and by we I mean the Ducks because... I'm not.
We showed you what the offense actually looks like when you've been doing it for longer than a year.
This is what happens when you see the master do their work.
Mm-hmm.
And they did it very impressively. I'm not going to say that, you know, Washington Stadium wasn't crazy. He can tell you that because he was there.
It was insane.
It was pretty wild.
It was loud in there. It was definitely everything that Washington fans claim it is. It's loud.
It is.
Is it Autzen loud? Well, I mean, they're close. But it really didn't matter about the noise because when you have a good team like Oregon that just comes in there and they just systematically take whatever you do well and turn it against you and there's nothing you can do about it, it doesn't matter what kind of noise you make. It doesn't matter what type of signs you say you have or what types of things you call us. It doesn't matter what types of national championships you claim you have, because on that particular day and for the last 10 years.
The last nine.
Those national championships haven't meant a thing. All that is for you to hold solace after you get your butt cleaned every single year. We have dominated and will continue to dominate for quite some time.
Mm-hmm.
Because I really don't see Washington beating Oregon anytime soon, as long as we continue to get the recruits that we get and continue to keep the system in place and the coaches in place and everything that we have going. Yeah, I really just can't see it.
This was the big test for Mark Helfrich, and he passed it with flying colors. And one thing, this really pissed me off. Everybody was saying that Washington thinks that they're more physical than Oregon. They're
I heard that all, you know, the whole time I was up there on Seattle's radio station is that Washington.
You heard some stuff on Seattle's radio.
Yeah, Washington was under the impression that Oregon was soft. That Oregon's defense was soft, their offense was soft, that they were spoiled, and that they just were the benefactors of playing a bunch of nobodies. Well. And Washington was supposed to be the lunch pail defense that, you know, hits harder, you know, is faster, makes more plays. But you hadn't played anybody really worth note either. And
outside
so
Stanford.
So you play Oregon, and then Oregon shows you, well, you still are a long ways off, and this was your best team to date, which has to really make you upset.
Yeah, Mariota tore Washington apart. I think he only threw
six incomplete passes.
Seven.
Two of them.
Two of them were drop balls, and one of those was the most wide open thing I've ever seen.
So, I mean, really, the score could have been a lot more lopsided than it was. And, you know, being that Mark Helfrich is well aware of the rivalry, you're lucky that he didn't just keep everybody in and continue.
Because he could have. That fourth quarter, they took
their foot
off the gas.
Yeah, he could have pulled a Neuheisel and just continuously kept going for it and rubbing it in your face, and then everybody dances on the W and does all that stuff and gets out of hand.
We definitely tried to dance on the W.
We did.
They just didn't let us.
Right.
Which, you know, whatever. But my favorite thing was watching Oregon's defense, which – really, it seems like everybody wanted to discredit that. Well, they definitely showed you why everybody says Oregon has a good defense now.
Yep.
Oregon is actually number one in the Pac-12 in, I think, it's either four or five defensive categories. Pass efficiency defense, which was previously held by Washington, but we show that was fool's gold. Let's see, yards per play allowed is another one. Points per game, and there's one other one, I can't quite remember what it is, but obviously Oregon's defense is pretty damn salty.
And playing in a league like this where everybody spreads you out and you don't have very many pro-style offenses anymore, everybody's pretty much a spread team or an air raid team, that's pretty impressive considering that you know, unlike teams like, you know, in the SEC or something that just play pretty much pro-style offenses where they can hold teams to, you know, 200 yards of offense. Oregon doing what they do and containing the people they contain, even though they may give up 300 yards of total offense here and there, that's pretty impressive considering that, you know, Oregon runs into these types of teams every single week.
Mm-hmm.
And Washington is no exception. They, you know, came into this game scoring quite a few points themselves and being pretty, you know, efficient moving the ball and having a pretty good defense, and Oregon just took everything.
Oregon's secondary locked down the passing game.
It was incredible. Everything Washington was doing well before the game had started going into this series against Oregon, Oregon just pretty much took it all away, with the exception of Bishop Sankey, just because I think he's really good, and he got his yards.
And then realistically, had it not been for that 65-yard run, and that kind of freakish 20-something yard run, he really didn't have a great game. Oregon's front seven, or their front four even, totally dominated the line of scrimmage, which...
five sacks?
That's what physical defense is like, my friends.
Yep.
They flushed Teeth Price out of the pocket more times than I can count on.
And not to mention, pretty much just baptized him into the ground. I mean,
a lot.
Over and over, and he was, at the end of the game, you could see he was getting up slower and slower and slower. And I'm pretty sure that if you're a finesse defense, that's not something you do. You don't hurt people.
Yeah, that's what a soft defense is like.
Yeah, right? I'm pretty sure that both teams were feeling some. I know Josh Huff got hurt, and I know Tony Washington sprained his ankle.
He got hurt, and then he came back out and had a 65-yard touchdown.
Yep.
Because you play through
him. And that's also what tough teams do that aren't weak and that aren't soft, is they come back and they make plays.
You know
who didn't get hurt? Marcus Mariota.
Yep.
You know why?
Because he can't.
Right.
He did some things that I didn't even think was possible.
He's a robot.
He is.
He's not a human.
Yeah, he's a robot built to be a Heisman.
Yep. That's what he is. Made out of pineapples from Hawaii.
His spatial awareness is just gross. He knew where everybody was at all times. He knew where the defenders were at all times, and he knew how to make everybody miss. With the exception of a couple of plays where he tried to scramble for touchdowns, which
how frustrating must it be though for your defense to go from a traditional 4-3 defense to playing even a 3-down line set with 4 linebackers, thinking that you're going to contain, you're going to blitz, and you're going to keep him in the pocket, and he still runs right around everybody, or he still makes plays regardless of whatever it is that you do or whatever it is you throw at him. And, you know, for Sarkisian and for Wilcox, that must be, and even for the fans, that's got to be so frustrating. And it was so great watching all of this stuff happen, and I'm sitting there in the end zone, and I'm watching all these things, and I'm watching all these Husky fans, and they're just face in palm, shaking their head, taking off their hats, throwing it on the ground.
Sarkisian doing the duck face on the sideline.
He totally did it.
Exactly like that.
Totally did it. And I'm sitting there just loving it. And the guy behind me is the biggest dick of all time. And he's sitting here saying, you know, Oregon's really only been relevant since 2009. And, you know, they're only good because of Phil Knight. And, you know, blah, 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 blah. And I'm like, come on. You know, 10 years worth is longer than 2009. And if you really feel that way about Oregon, then it really must suck that you're losing to a team that has no national championships, that isn't winning.
Yeah, if Oregon hasn't been relevant since 2009, still couldn't beat us for that other span of 6 years.
You really, really, really must be hating your life.
Mm-hmm.
But I don't really care what any Washington fan says about national championships or about conference championships or Rose Bowls, because every single time that we beat you just makes it even more sweet, because you keep coming up with the same recycled bull crap every single year. And it never changes because we keep blowing you out by 20 or more.
And that's all you can hang your hat on.
And that's fine. You know, you want to keep talking about, take pictures of your 2 national championships that you really didn't win anyway because you never played for them, then hey, that's fine. To me, that's just really like having 0 championships because somebody just handed you one and said, hey.
That's pretty much like saying,
we think you're the best team too, so you can have one also. Come on. I mean, it's just retarded. Washington fans are some of the weirdest,
most delusional
people I've ever talked to in my entire life. And
not even about just college football.
I think that's just what makes this rivalry even better, and why we keep winning. It just makes it more sweet every single time because
they get more bitter.
Yeah,
they every get single more year. Upset. And they know that there's nothing they can do about it because they're not going to beat us. Until you beat us, you really can't say anything.
And can you imagine what kind of party that's going to be like? I'll bet Seattle just blows up.
It'll be a riot.
Yeah.
Because technically.
And that's what's really sad, is that you guys will have such a big celebration over beating Oregon for the first time, and who knows how long it'll be, that it'll be that big of a deal.
And then we'll just go back to beating
you. And then we'll just go back to beating you again and start a new streak. But it really, you know, right now we're just going to enjoy this because we took so much heat all week long from Washington fans and even USC fans jumping on the bandwagon trying to, you know.
Which still doesn't make any sense to me, by the way.
Yeah, they're just a bunch of jock riders. I don't know. But anyway, I'm just going to enjoy this one. I know everybody, every other Duck fan's enjoying this.
Oh, yeah, of course.
You know, and really, you know, there's really not a whole lot else we need to say because the scoreboard tells a tale.
Numbers never lie, my friends.
Numbers never lie. And I think I'm just waiting for the comment board. Oh, well, how many championships does Oregon have? Zero, just like their logo.
Yeah, that's
never
original.
Never heard that one before.
I know.
It really doesn't matter. You guys can claim your little national championships you never really played for, and that's fine.
Whatever.
Well, you know what? How many wins does Washington have this decade against Oregon?
Zero.
And how many winless seasons does Oregon have in its history? Zero. How many do you have? One.
In the old Pac-10.
Yeah. 12. You went 0-12. As bad as we've been, we have never been 0-12. Not once.
Mm-hmm.
So you can hang your hat on that then. And that you know, I can't stand Washington.
Yeah.
And I'm so incredibly happy that we blew them out again playing the offense.
Especially when they're saying, well, now that Chip Kelly's gone, there's nothing holding us back from winning this game, except for the part where Mark Helfrich is every bit as good of a coach as Chip Kelly
like
was.
Like we said before Chip Kelly left, and everybody thought we were being absolutely retarded for saying it, but we have not lost one step. We have not missed one beat.
We may have actually even gained a step.
We might, because we're playing
that
better
now
that
this year.
You can call that a bold statement. You can call that retarded if you want, but I think in a lot of ways, Mark Helfrich is a better coach than Chip Kelly. He still has all the ballsy moves that Chip Kelly has. He is not nearly as stubborn as Chip Kelly was. I can tell you that. If there's anything about Chip Kelly that bothered the living hell out of me, is that he would run the same damn play a million times until it worked, if it wasn't working. Helfrich doesn't do that. He has way more creativity in his offense, and that is deadly.
Well, it just is what it is. Oregon is just better right now. Oregon has been better for the last 10 years. Oregon is 14 and, you know, now we're 15-4 since 1994. So overall, for the last, you know, 18 years, we have just dominated, and we'll continue to dominate. And Washington fans are just going to have to get used to some things, and that's just us being better at football than you.
Mm-hmm.
So, with that said, I think we can end this video on a Go Ducks. We have won the decade, and Husky fans, go huck yourself.
Mm-hmm. As you were. See you later. We'll come back and talk to you guys in about 300 and something days when we come and beat you again. So, get ready for that. Until then,
Go Ducks.
This is the O. See you later. Zero wins. Zero more wins in the next decade.
The next decade.
Hey, that's life. Everybody's got a story.
Everybody has one.